October is National Movie Month, when the best of the newest movies will be shown at your favorite theaters. Join the world and share the romance, color, adventure, hilarity, excitement, and splendor that spell movies during National Movie Month. Be here in October. It's National Movie Month.
Jim Rex? What's Jim Rex? Would you believe a movie audience guide presented as a public service by this theater's management to help you select your motion picture entertainment? Well, that's what it is. And we urge you to learn these rating symbols and use them as a guide for you and your family. G means suggested for general audiences, all ages. M, suggested for mature audiences, parental discretion advised. R, restricted, persons under 16 not admitted unless accompanied by parent or adult guardian. X, persons under 16 will not be admitted. This seal in advertising indicates that the film was approved under the Motion Picture Code of Self-Regulation.
You will see in the movie Pieces cannot be revealed, cannot be described, cannot even be imagined. And you don't have to go to Texas for a chainsaw massacre. Pieces, it's exactly what you think it is. Pieces. Absolutely no one under 17 will be admitted.
Began in a peaceful community, a place that had never known evil until now. But 20 years ago, in the stillness beneath these waters, something happened. And now, its deadly spawn has been released. Coming up from the depths, out into the light. Slugs. First, they got into the water system. Now they'll get into your system.
Oh my God!
They ooze.
There's something down there that's killing people.
They slime.
We got a new dead body showing up every 10 minutes.
They kill.
We're dealing with a mutant form of slug here, a kind that eats meat.
It has three or four rows of teeth.
Don't turn on the tap. Don't go in the basement.
No, get out of it! No, no, no.
Steer clear of the sewers. And whatever you do, don't make out while your parents aren't home. Slugs. It may be the most shocking movie you will ever see. Slugs.
Authorities declare the Bronx a high-risk zone. There's only one alternative. Destroy it. Destroy it. Escape from the Bronx. Escape from the Bronx. Escape from the Bronx.
In 2 weeks, Columbia Pictures will present 3D as you've never seen it before. The first quality 3D film backed by a major studio. The first to use a new state-of-the-art 3D process. This is Space Hunter, Adventures in the Forbidden Zone. It's the story of three unlikely heroes. Their destination, the Forbidden Zone. Their mission, save three stranded women.
I like her.
Their chances, one in a million.
I'll take that bet.
Columbia Pictures presents outer space as you've never seen it before. The ultimate 3D experience.
Can't anything be simple anymore?
Space Hunter, Adventures in the Forbidden Zone. In 3D, the first movie that puts you in outer space. Rated PG. Coming soon to a theater near you.
It's funny. One night you go to bed, and when you wake up, everything is different. Now Brian's acting a little peculiar.
He's like a completely different person. I don't even know him anymore.
Something's gotten into him.
Sometimes everything glows with a different kind of light.
Deep into him.
What are you telling me? That we killed someone last night?
Something bad.
Hacky, Brian. Hacky.
Something slimy.
What are you doing?
Something very...
I know something's happened to you.
Very...
The hell is that?
Hungry.
You can't keep killing people every time you're hungry.
You are mine now, Brian. I own you.
Gotta get out of here fast. Go where?
You're a wreck, Brian.
Leave me alone!
Whenever you want to stop hurting, you come to me.
Brain damage. It will turn you inside out.
First, he created the most frightening film ever made. Then, he took his unique vision of terror one step further. Now, George A. Romero takes us out of the night, beyond the dawn, and into the darkest day of horror the world has ever known. Day of the Dead.
There have to be survivors in Washington.
Oh, my.
They have more sophisticated shelters than this one.
Oh,
there have to be people in those shelters who know about us, who know where we are. With no radio contact, they'll come looking for us.
I said shut up!
They can be tricked into being good little girls and boys. The same way we were tricked into it on the promise of some reward to come.
What the fuck is wrong with you people? They're dead! They're fucking dead, and you want to teach them tricks?
They have to be rewarded, Captain.
Why else will they do what we want them to do?
I don't want them to do anything but Droppo!
George A. Romero's Day of the Dead, the most eagerly awaited day in horror film history.
Was our 20th century expert.
Expert?
Yes, that's from the committee.
I come from the future, from a city that travels in time, and we can choose what time zone we want to appear in. Right now, it should be around the end of the 32nd century. It's coming back in time.
What really happens when the city lands?
There's going to be a battle out there soon.
These Genviki, are they human?
Only by a stretch of the imagination.
And what about you? Are you human?
Back up the line, they're still discussing that.
Form the triangle. Storm the city. Destroy them all.
Time Guardian. Starring Carrie Fisher, Princess Leia in Star Wars.
Just so we understand each other, mister, the moment that circuit closes, I'm in charge.
The hell you are!
Dean Stockwell.
You've been given a job to do, Smith. Now do it.
And Tom Berlinson as the Time Guardian.
Now listen, if we don't break through, we're all dead. Let's get these tin cans. Go, go!
Time Guardian. Things are going to get pretty ugly in the year 4039. Herbert West is at the top of his class in medical school.
How can you teach such drivel? These people are here to learn and you're closing their minds before they even have a chance.
What are
He's
you...
brilliant, but a little weird.
I've broken the 6 to 12 minute barrier. I've conquered brain death.
His experiments have always been unorthodox.
It was dead.
But lately they're getting out of hand. And he's just made a discovery that could wake up the dead.
Herbert West has effected reanimation in dead animal tissue.
What are you thinking? How do you feel?
You?
15 cc's of reagent being administered.
Once you wake up the dead, you've got a real mess on your hands.
Dead?
Not anymore.
Herbert West brought a lot of dead people back to life. And not one of them showed any appreciation. H.P. Lovecraft's classic tale of horror, Reanimator.
Mr. West.
You'll never get credit for my discovery. Who's going to believe a talking head? Get a job in a sideshow.
It will scare you to pieces.
They broke into the mall for the wildest all-night party of their lives.
They're dead meat.
But you're never alone in the chopping mall.
What's that?
Robot blood.
Chopping mall. Where shopping costs you an arm and a leg.
Buried within the uncharted depths of waters surrounding a group of islands off the 50th parallel lies man's most formidable challenge. The awesome awakening of prehistoric monsters long thought extinct. Science was baffled and powerless. A terror-stricken humanity knew that it was on the brink of total destruction. A once proud civilization now had to place its trust and hope in Godzilla and his powerful ally, Robot Man. In concert, they would fight this evil in a duel to the death. Battling by day, battling by night, it was more than a race against time. This war was an all-out effort whose ultimate purpose was to save our planet from total destruction. Now came the moment of truth. The ultimate battle. Against Titan, giant against giant in the most spectacular battle yet. You'll see it all in Godzilla versus Megalon.
When you have ghosts. But who do you call when you have monsters?
We're the Monster Squad.
What's a squad? It's like Miami Vice, I think.
They're young and inexperienced.
Naughty virgin!
They're a bit disorganized.
Monsters are not real.
We don't know that, sir.
2,000-year-old dead guys do not get up and walk away by themselves!
But when strange things start happening in town...
There's a monster in my closet.
Ooh, look at that big, scary monster!
What's happening?
You wait to kill a werewolf.
Silver bullet?
They're the only ones ready to do battle.
Something's out there that's killing people. And if it's monsters, nobody's gonna do a thing about it but us.
Soon the creatures of the night will rule the world.
Real monsters? Us? Midnight. In the world, remember? Maybe we can be like Mask Squad instead, you know? Do mask bombs.
We got a 1035. Sit back up. Hurry it
up. Or Nature Squad. The book is right. Don't you see it's all true?
By midnight.
You guys.
They won't seem so young anymore. The Monster Squad.
Wolfman's got NARS!
100 years ago, between midnight and one, something unnatural came out of the fog. Now, it has returned. Years ago, between midnight and one, something evil came out of the fog. Now it has returned.
Who's there?
The fog.
Antonio Bay has a curse on it. We're all cursed.
Some water got in here, but something awful cold did.
I think I'll go to Vancouver now. Where's the fog now?
Well, it should be right outside my door now.
Oh, there's something different about this fog. Dan, stay away from the door! Someone listen to me!
Get inside and lock your doors. Close your windows. There's something in the fog. Stay away from the fog. From the creator of Halloween, the ultimate experience in terror and suspense. John Carpenter's The Fog, starring Adrian Barbeau, Jamie Lee Curtis, John Houseman, Janet Leigh as Kathy Williams, and Hal Holbrook as Father Malone. The fog. What you can't see won't hurt you. It will kill you. Between midnight and one, it will find you.
Five years ago, Stephen King and George Romero, two masters of the macabre, created their hallmark of horror, Creepshow. Many would argue that nothing of significance has happened since. Until now. Maybe you don't get out much.
Oh, this is crazy. This is totally crazy.
Maybe you're always running late.
I gotta go.
Or maybe you just have other things on your mind.
Hey, they gotta make me a movie star.
But if you only make it to one scary film all year, make it one you remember all year long. Creepshow 2. If you like movies that will keep you stuck to your chair. Stephen King and George Romero have conjured up an all-new Creepshow.
No! It's impossible!
Just for you.
I mean, what is it?
I don't know.
So don't just sit there.
And I'm gonna swim for it right now.
Walk. Run. Swim if you have to.
I've got you!
But whatever you do, don't take your time. Because the scares come twice as quickly in...
I-B-U!
Creepshow 2.
Preview you are about to watch is for a movie that is unlike any you have ever seen before. It is for a movie that goes beyond temporary fear to everlasting terror. It is a movie called Demons. Yes, the demons are coming, and they're coming for you. Warning. If you have the courage to see demons, sit near an exit. Otherwise, you might never get out. In your theater, who will survive the touch of the demons and who will not? Demons. With music by Billy Idol, Motley Crue, The Adventures, Rick Springfield, and Saxon. This is no dream. This is happening right now. Could be happening to you. will make cemeteries their cathedrals, and the cities will be your tombs. Will you survive it? Demons.
Stand by for the most extraordinary chain of events ever swept up into high adventure.
Hey, Larry, where's the forklift?
Forklift! It's over there by the baggage loader.
Airplane. Airplane is drama.
This is Dr. Brody at the Mayo Clinic. There's a passenger on your Chicago flight 209er, a little girl named Lisa Davis, en route to Minneapolis. She's scheduled for a heart transplant. I want you to make sure that she's kept in a reclined position and that a continuous watch is kept on her IV.
Airplane is action. Airplane is romance.
I love you, Elaine.
I love you.
Airplane is music.
There is only one river. There is only one sea.
Airplane is dancing. Never has the screen been so big.
You ever been in a cockpit before?
No, sir, I've never been up in a plane before.
Peter Graves.
You ever seen a grown man naked?
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
My name is Roger Murdoch. I'm an airline pilot.
Leslie Nielsen.
This woman has to be gotten to a hospital.
A hospital? What is it?
It's a big building with patients, but that's not important right now.
Lloyd Bridges.
Johnny, what can you make out of this?
This? Well, I could make a hat. Or a brooch. Or a pterodactyl. Could you get
Robert Stack.
All right, Steve, let's face a few facts.
And we hope you enjoy the rest of your flight.
Julie Haggerty.
By the way, is there anyone on board who knows how to fly a plane?
Can you fly this plane and land it?
Robert Hayes.
Surely you can't be serious.
I am serious, and don't call me Shirley.
I've got to get out of here.
Please, let me handle this.
Calm down. Now get back to your seat. I'll take care of this. Calm down. Get a hold of yourself.
Don't be one of the phone. Everything's been pulled.
Mayday. Mayday.
The most incredible adventure the screen has ever created.
He's coming right at us!
The big news is... Airplane.
The terror of the past is but a taste of the future. What happened before was a hint of the horror to come. The first time was only a warning. William Holden, Lee Grant, Damien, Omen 2.
Tell me about Damien. What sort of a boy is he?
He's your brother's son. He's a boy you've loved for 7 years. Well, you can't believe this.
And?
It's over. It is a filthy, stupid story, and it's over.
The current's got him!
You mustn't attract attention.
You're not going to treat Damien any differently. You're not going to look at him. You're not going to talk to him any differently.
The day will come when everyone will know who you are, but that day is not yet.
I know who you are. Say it, Mark.
Get Mark away from Damien.
Look at me, Mark.
Damien, there are things you don't understand. Read your Bible.
Ah!
He needs me.
I need you.
Damien, Omen 2.
Why only other boys and not Damien?
I don't understand.
Damien has a different cell structure.
Different? What does it mean?
I've been working on the story for years now. I think I pieced it together. Oh, please, please, you must listen to me.
The first time was only a warning.
Five deaths. Five unexplained, horrible accidents. We are all in great danger.
You can't make me believe it.
You've got to believe it. He killed Mark. He killed Atherton and Vissarion. And he'll keep on killing. He'll kill anyone he thinks is threatening him.
Listen to yourself. Listen to how crazy it sounds.
Man, I saw Charles killed. I saw Damien's face on the wall.
William Holden.
Where's Damien?
Lee Grant. Damien, Omen 2. The first time was only a warning.
Hidden inside the house at 21 Shady Lane Avenue is a black and white TV with the power to turn itself on and come alive with the dead, the video dead. But for the new owners, their first warning may be too late.
Why did you kill her?
You don't know what you're messing with.
The video dead. A new form and shape for zombie terror that invades a neighborhood and threatens the innocent, the unsuspecting, and the unbelieving. Nothing can prepare you. Nothing can save you. Nothing can stop the onslaught of the video dead. It's the late show to end them all. Look what's buried inside your TV. The video dead.
Someone is coming back to Elm Street. He is not friendly. He is not patient.
Get off of me!
And he is not a welcome visitor.
Hey, no! 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 No!
But he has something terribly special for the new kid on the block.
It started to happen again.
Dad!
I'm in trouble.
You've had some scary dreams, okay?
Help!
Daddy can't help you now.
There's something inside of
him. Fight him! You are not afraid of him. He doesn't even exist.
No!
Freddy Krueger is back on Elm Street.
Get out of here, Lisa!
Jesse, fight him!
Watch out for him. He'll be in your neighborhood soon.
You are all my children now.
A Nightmare on Elm Street, Part 2.
You've got the body. I've got the brain.
Freddy's Revenge.
Elm Street Part 3. Freddy's just around the corner.
What would you do if you accidentally discovered the house next door was occupied by something not human? Something horrifying. Something unspeakably evil. No one believes you.
Mom, I didn't have a nightmare.
Not your mom.
They did kill a girl over there.
Not your girlfriend.
Charlie, is this some sort of a trick to get me back?
Not even the police.
Look, I know it's crazy. I know that, but look, Lieutenant!
It knows that you know. You'll do anything to protect yourself. But it will do anything to protect its secret. Being scared. This could be the night of your life.
We are a rescue team, not assassins. Now, what do we gotta do?
In a part of the world where there are no rules.
We pick up their trail at the chopper, run them down, grab those hostages before anybody knows we were there. What do you mean we?
Deep in the jungle, where nothing that lives is safe.
You lose it here, you're in a world of hurt.
Showtime!
Yeah.
Knock, knock.
An elite rescue squad.
You're bleeding, man.
I ain't got time to bleed.
Is being led by the ultimate warrior.
We need the best. That's why you're here.
But now...
What's got Billy so spooked?
There's something out there waiting for us. And it ain't no man. They're up against the ultimate enemy.
Holy Mother of God.
Nothing like it has ever been on Earth before.
She says the jungle just came alive and took him.
We cannot see it.
No blood, no bodies. We hit nothing.
But it sees the heat of our bodies and the heat of our fear.
Whatever it is out there, it killed Hopper. And now it wants us.
It kills for pleasure.
He was skinned alive!
It hunts for sport.
He's killing us one at a time.
We're all gonna die.
But this time, it's picked the wrong man to hunt.
If it bleeds, we can kill it.
Century Fox presents Arnold Schwarzenegger. Predator. The hunt begins Friday, June 12th at theaters everywhere.
More than anything else, Cal Jameson wants to leave the horror of his old life behind. Now, in his new life, he's about to discover that the real horror is just beginning.
Don't you come any closer!
Did you see what they did to the kid in there?
You said he found the body on an altar with a lot of religious paraphernalia, right?
A religion as old as time.
One life from each of us counts.
Versus an unimaginable force for evil.
This ritual's being performed now.
One life was all he had.
Nothing can stop them.
It's a power you can't imagine.
Want them to know who you are? Do you?
What have they done to you, Sean?
I can't move.
No one can help you.
I got my shield. Don't you get it?
You looked into his eyes, and you both felt the power of the man who killed them.
Jessica!
They know who you are.
Chris was chosen, Cal. When he found the shell, it was a sign.
We want you to join us.
$4 million. Hidden in four different places. $1 million in each place.
DEG presents Million Dollar Mystery.
Federal agents, free.
A madcap race to riches.
They must be crazy.
Sure, they're my folks.
5, 6, 7, 8.
They're all after a fortune, and nothing is going to stand in their way.
Surrender or rest!
There are millions hidden somewhere nearby.
Okay, nobody move.
And these wild and crazy people will do almost anything to find it.
Red.
Red.
The money is secure.
The most rewarding movie ever made. Million Dollar Mystery.
So there's still $3 million left. It's gotta be somewhere.
How many lottery tickets they would buy?
You'll find high-speed chases, wild excitement, mysterious clues.
That way.
Oh, no.
Adventure that falls from the sky. It's more than a movie. It's your chance to win $1 million cash.
We found the money!
For the first time in motion picture history, one lucky person who solves the million-dollar mystery will win $1 million cash from DEG. No purchase necessary. Details coming soon at local theaters and on specially marked Glad packages.
Hey, there's our movers!
Chevy Chase is leaving the city to live in the country.
See you up there!
Who the hell is that? How should I know?
Surrounded by Earth's little living treasures.
Mosquito.
With room to roam for his loyal dog.
Is it alive?
A place where he can bond with nature.
Oh! Ah!
And hook up with a few close friends. Where people take pride in their jobs.
That maniac is our mailman.
Where home is safe.
Mindy!
And secure. Where all the food tastes like mom's. And all the neighbors treat you like family.
I have good news. We've decided to stay.
Chevy Chase, Funny Farm.
This mission's important, John.
I want you to come with me to help me lead the team.
I put in my time.
What's that mean?
It means my war's over.
He never draws first blood. The first time was for himself. The second time was for his country.
All right, move it!
This time...
Rambo, something went wrong.
It's for his friend.
What do you expect us to do? Send in a Delta team? Create an international incident?
What about me?
By the way you look, I can see you have no experience in war.
Fired a few shots.
But if you're captured, we'll deny any participation or even knowledge of your existence.
Sounds familiar.
I know he's your friend. But you cannot do this. You both will die. For what?
Just do it for me.
No!
What do you think this man is?
God!
Oh, God, would have mercy. He wants...
Who are you?
Your worst nightmare.
Stallone. Rambo 3.
I'm sorry I got you into this, John. No, you're not.
the world's favorite adventurer, is back for more.
Mick!
Yeah?
You're back!
Yeah?
You're back!
Yes, Bob.
I missed you.
I know.
The drinks are on the house.
More action. More excitement.
Don't try to stop me.
I don't want to stop you, I just want to get past.
I'm about to throw myself off this building.
Would you mind getting a move on? I'm on my lunch break.
More fun.
Follow the ball?
Nah, mate.
What did he say?
He wants to know if we're allowed to eat these men.
And more of everything.
What's he like in bed? I don't know. He still sleeps on the floor.
Paul Hogan is Michael J. Crocodile Dundee.
Hey, hey, Sarge.
I might have known it would be you.
Is this New York fish, Sarge? I want to take a bite.
Crocodile Dundee 2.
You can get everything you ever wanted in a movie. In one movie. You can get high.
Get low.
Get flip. Get a glow.
Get hot.
Get bizarre.
Dive! I'm on!
Get a plane.
Get a car.
Get out!
Get in.
Get religion.
Get sin.
Get caressed. Get undressed.
Get molested.
Get arrested.
Evening, officer.
But most of all, get crazy. Get it while it's hot. Get it if you're not. Come and get it. Get crazy. What Animal House did to college, an airplane did to flying, Get Crazy does to rock and roll. Get Crazy, coming soon to a theater near you.
There comes a time in every girl's life when she knows she's not a little girl anymore. Inga, at 16, at her coming of age, learns everything there is to know about love.
I like to be alone, like you, to do just what I want.
And he turns to kiss you and you smile and you feel...
This new dress is really something. I wonder what Mother would say if she saw you like this.
There comes a time when she has new interests, a new awareness in her mind, a new feeling in her body.
What smells so good?
Like it? It's nothing dangerous. You would like it. It's very relaxing, you know.
This is my sister Inga. You know, Bjorn, he's a painter. Where's Kirsten?
I don't know.
Kirsten?
Bjorn will be a very good influence on you. You know, he smokes, he drinks, and he even...
There comes a time in every girl's life when she knows she has so much to give.
You have a great thing going, playing naive and innocent, but really you're a little slut.
That's not true.
Excuse me, what do you call it?
Good night. I'm sorry I acted like a child.
There comes a time in every girl's life when waiting and wanting aren't enough.
I don't believe you.
What do you mean?
I don't believe you're free.
What, like this? Did you wear it like that? Of course. Did everybody look at you?
There comes a time in every girl's life when she can't escape growing up. There comes a time in Inga's life when she can't escape being loved.
The taste of love was a night that you'll never forget.
Christina Lindbergh, the girl with them. You've seen her in Playboy, you've seen her in Penthouse. Now starring in Made in Sweden. In an unforgettable weekend in Stockholm, you'll see all of her. There comes a time in Inga's life when she becomes a woman. Made in Sweden. Rated X and then some.
You know what winning that contest means to me and my friends. 5 years we've been playing 15 bucks a night club dates in places like Modesto and Redwood City.
And you really think you have a chance to win?
We're gonna be up there on that stage in the finals.
Pinsky, Daniel. Height, 6 feet. Weight, 150 pounds. Occupation, part-time in a cab.
Sorry.
Part-time on a stage.
Love is why I live.
Full-time, on the run.
Hey! Ooh. What's the matter with you, man? You sick? Oh.
He's wanted.
Count of five, Pinsky.
Wanted by the police for 78 parking tickets.
Taxi.
And 3 murders.
It's not that I had a chance to clear myself. Now I'm a murderer on the front page.
Morning.
Wanted by a girl named Amy.
That's real good, huh?
Forever.
Fine, Pinsky.
Pursued by just about everyone for a monkey.
Get off me! Get off me!
Everybody's killing each other for a monkey?
Precisely.
You little nothing. You little nit. This ain't no ordinary monkey.
One of our men is missing in action.
Pinsky's out there somewhere in no man's land. Cut off from his outfit. Look for Pinsky over hill. Over Dale! Over every dusty trail!
The halls of the Cow Palace to the shores of Sausalito! Men, find them!
Who are you? What is this place? Who are those goons out there? Why can't I go? What's going on here?
Motion picture that shows the world how to succeed in rock and roll without really dying.
What does anything mean without love?
Gas pump girls are having fun now that school is out and the whole town is there for the making.
Remember everything I have to do.
Don't worry, it's just 4 easy steps. Grab it, stick it in, squeeze it, and let it peter out.
Gas Pump Girls, a motion picture delight when our girls change over a gas station and turn it into a fun station with sounds that will get you dancing while your tank is getting filled.
We'll treat it like
there's
no one else in the world.
What's going on here?
I love it.
Hey, girls! Woo! Hey!
Come on, let's go check this thing out.
Hey, gorgeous. Can I help you with anything?
Yeah. Could you hold this for me?
Anyway you do it, there's gonna be magic to it.
Girls have so much
much trouble with these things.
Just what is it you're selling here?
Gas.
You gonna pump gas in my little pickup here?
Would you like regular or super duper?
Cause any way you do it, there's gonna be magic to it.
Gas Pump Girls. Drive in and check them out. Rated R. Under 17, not admitted without parent. Jack and Cecil are two of a kind. They like to think of themselves as the last of the plainsmen. What they really are is a half-caste Indian and a misfit cowboy. Two rustlers determined to hustle their share of Rancho Deluxe and grab as much of the action as they can handle. Starring Jeff Bridges, Sam Waterson, Elizabeth Ashley, Charlene Dallas, Harry Dean Stanton. It started as fun, but before it's over, the laughter isn't all that will die. Every cowboy has a dream of having his own Rancho Deluxe. The only thing that's different is how they go about getting it.
New breed, reckless and violent on a collision course with the establishment. Headed for hell on chopped down hogs. Hating each other, but hating the establishment more.
Listen, Charlie. We've had enough of your kind of help.
You black animal.
Yeah, a panther, honky.
Black angels, a pack of snarling wolves in a fury of burning rubber and blood. Crashing head on with brutal fury, soaking the streets with blood.
Don't push me, Chainer.
Why not? You push me, you push us, you push everybody.
Don't play games, huh?
A wild bunch of women, untamed and shameless, turning on for kicks. Hey, Black Angels grabbing every kick along the way.
Yeah, I'm a new Sailor Black.
I'll bust you wide open.
You ain't busting nobody, Whitey.
Thundering hordes of bikers clashing head-on in the most violent bike movie ever filmed.
You slummy dimple!
Black Angels exploding out of the slums, slamming into the establishment. Black Angel soaring across the screen in an unforgettable drama of raging anger, breaking out on wheels. Danger is their life, death their destiny. Black Angel, savage, brutal, fierce. Don't miss it. American International Pictures. Rated R, restricted, under 17, requires accompanying parent or adult guardian.
Film Festival. 48 films were presented from around the world. They were made by the most renowned directors and featured the biggest name stars in entertainment. But look what happened. A film called Jeremy, directed by an unknown and starring two actors no one has ever heard of, not only won a major award, but in fact was voted the most popular film of the entire festival by the general public.
I have a blue balloon, a happy tune, low enough to let me off the air.
still in the lead. Two Mets and Favor City in a close second and third. As they come into the stretch, that's Triple Bat and Tunick. That's Triple Bat and Tunick. Triple Bat and Tunick as they cross the wire. It's Triple Bat.
Does anyone else know you do this?
Nope. It's a secret.
Good. I wouldn't tell them if I were you.
You know what else I do?
What?
Promise you won't laugh?
I promise.
Well, sometimes when I'm walking down the street, I see some guy ahead of me. You know, just any guy. Well, I want to race him. You know, just me and him. I create an imaginary finish line. I call the race in my head.
I don't believe it.
M. Miller. The man in the blue suit has a two-length lead as they come out of the starting gate, and Jeremy Jones is a disappointing second. On the outside, Jeremy makes his move. At the 16th pole, that's Jones and the man in the blue suit, neck and neck. As they're coming down the home stretch, that's head and head. The man in the blue suit and Jeremy Jones. The man in the blue suit and Jeremy Jones. As they cross the wall. And it's Jeremy Jones.
Jeremy, a film with nothing going for it, but the people who love it.
Corey Webster is taking off for LA. He lives to thrash. He loves to compete. But the competition is a killer.
Check it out, it's hooking the dance.
Beautiful girl at the club.
The music of the Bangles, Animotion, Devo, Meatloaf, the Red Hot Chili Peppers, thrashing.
Well, what do you thrash?
What do you got?
You'd like to be held like that?
Yeah, I'd love it.
An uphill romance.
Corey, please don't go.
To a downhill race. It's not a kid's game anymore.
Saturday night in Alphabet City.
Gino.
Pro,
1 hour, Tony.
Nose, nose, candy trees.
At 19, they gave Johnny the streets and everything on them. Tonight, they want it all back.
Remember one thing, Johnny? Nobody's indispensable, you know what I mean?
No, 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 not sleep.
Trust me.
Juniper, the word out, man. The word is you're dead.
Welcome to Alphabet City.
Slow, man, slow!
If you're not on the way up, you're on the way out. Alphabet City, it heats up when the sun goes down. Alphabet City, starring Vincent Spano. Soundtrack available on Island Records and Tapes.
Lash your eyes up and take to the road.
Adam Gaines has a 911 T Porsche. Good looks. A guaranteed future. And as many girls as he can handle. When you're through with the hip and slip of it all, when the good life becomes too good, when the hard things come easy, then it's time to say so long, shift gears, and head for reality. The world changed for Adam at 6 a.m.
Adam Gaines. It's Gladys's boy from California.
Hello there, Adam. I just said to Jerry... This is my daughter, Jerry Jo. Hi, Adam.
Hello.
I said, now there's someone your own age for you to talk with on this dreadful afternoon.
You're not from Kansas City, I take it.
California.
Mm. Pharmacy's my field.
Semantics and ditch digging.
Well, just what is that now?
The semantics? Study of meanings.
Meanings of what?
Meanings of words.
Well, why doesn't a young man like yourself, present company accepted, of course, why doesn't he get up off his behind and make a buck?
Harvey Gammon.
Adam Gaines.
Yeah, I see you ain't used to hard work. Boy, you got yourself one hell of a good job now.
Got a job for the summer. Power and Light summer crew.
You won't like it. That's for men who never went to school.
Ah! Ah! No, God!
He's up! He's up! He's up! Help!
Let me tell you some big shot. I made you old lady Mavis. I did a hell of a witch away.
Get you up! No, no reason. I'm mad. Get out of here, Billy!
My God, now, get out!
You're different from us. You got brains. And now you got yourself the ball to go along with it.
Look, I don't want to be stopped in one place by somebody's idea of what's proper. I see you and me. Traveling all across the country. Europe, maybe a couple of years. Just go. We're two new people. All right? Let's try everything.
Lash your eyes up and take to the road. We got a long way to go.
Come on, Teen, get up. For God's sake, Teen, snap to it.
Your mother made Phi Beta Kappa at Smith, but I don't think she can make a four-minute egg.
Not tonight, I'm too tired.
Christ, is there anything you can do anymore?
Screwing appeal to you.
Diary of a Mad Housewife. A Frank Perry film with screenplay by Eleanor Perry from the novel by Sue Kaufman.
Hey,
9 days, we are giving a party for 100 people. I would like to see you do one thing to make this party a success.
We happen to have a fantastic sex thing. Sex is sex. A lay is a lay is a lay.
You really are a smart dame, but sometimes you've got a box full of marbles for a brain.
And you're a mean, cruel bastard, and you manage to spoil just about everything.
By far, Le Perry's best film. Great movie making. Superb performances. New York Times. An important film. Life magazine.
You've made love to a million different women, haven't you?
Give or take a dozen.
A pungent contemporary comedy. Playboy. A beautiful and dazzling piece of filmmaking, Holiday Magazine.
Certainly not a love affair.
Surpasses the Perry's David and Lisa and Last Summer, L.A. Herald Examiner. Witty dialogue. The biting truth is earthy, refreshing, and strangely satisfying. Cosmopolitan Magazine.
You're goddamn right I'm a sadist, and you're the perfect willing victim.
Blisters the current scene. The best Frank Perry has made. Saturday Review.
As usual, you've got everything twisted.
What have I got twisted? What have I got twisted?
Will be the most shattering film ever viewed by young married couples. Dorothy Manners, syndicated columnist.
Adventurers is here. Harold Robbins' sensational bestseller. Now the screen's most incredible entertainment. The Adventurers is here. All of it. All of them. Dax, Sue Ann, Fat Cat, Amparo, the beautiful people, the violent people. Run! These are the adventurers. Searching for passion. Reaching for power.
I, who made this country great. They envy me my position in history.
I hate you, Daxenos. Do you know that? I've got a present for you.
I'm the richest girl in the world. I don't find people. They find me.
500,000 and 5,000 a month is our last offer.
It looks so bad for the heir to one of the largest fortunes in the world to be a bastard.
I beg your pardon.
You two haven't met. Dax Zenas, my husband.
Is it true you've made love to every woman in this room?
Not yet.
When you were a child, you killed 7 men with that gun. Like it or not, Dax, you are involved.
Nothing has been left out of the adventurers. South America, New York, Paris, Venice, Rome, the Riviera, the glamorous playgrounds, the explosive battlegrounds. This is the world of the adventurers.
I trusted you. I would have done anything for you!
Someday I shall kill you for this!
I'd like to know what it is you really care about. You don't make love to girls. You make love at them.
Dax does not feel things like other men.
Nothing has been left out of the adventurers. Out of The Adventurers.
You know, it takes a special kind of guy to push them big old 18-wheelers down the highway. But they're a tough breed, them dudes. They make a 900-mile run in the blizzard look like a trip to church. Hi, this is Jerry Reed. We just finished shooting a motion picture about some of these good old boys. And before we got through with the ride, well, it got wilder than a can of crap. I play Iron Duke Borkin. You can't miss me. I'm the one on the screen with the cab over face.
Whoa, what's that extra $50? What is that?
That's for a hurry-up on a load.
You take an extra $50 and you stick it up where the sun don't shine. And if I wasn't in such a hurry, I'd stick around and assist you.
Now, Peter Pond is my buddy. We call him Rain. He's a lad with wheels in his head and a liking for fancy boots. And pretty little Helen Shaver's pickup. She's the one you boys gotta watch.
Jesus, scared me.
Mm-hmm. I told you about that little darling, didn't I?
What are you doing sneaking around outside?
Now, Peter and I play a couple of dudes who had a good thing going once, and we kind of get together again.
Best I can remember, me and you used to have a good time. You go take one more ride with the old dude.
But the way things are now, a fella get himself killed.
Well, I tried to be the kind of a gal you'd love to.
Excuse me. You want to dance?
No. Wait a minute. Hey.
Didn't need to go hunting for no trouble. We got engraved invitations.
Breaker 19, you've got the Iron Duke on a fly from a 1033. I'm being shot at with real bullets. You understand that? See if you can get on that radio and help me find a bear. A bunch of bears. Hell, I can use Air Force.
Look out, I'll take care of you, Smith.
Oh, take or get down in the seat. Your mama's gonna kill me now. Oh, me, why didn't I have a girl?
I can bring you to your knees, boy, but that don't mean that you have to crawl.
Give him one for the old
dude. We can find some backbone. When your eyes are against the bone, they may stack that deck against you, but you can die, so take your cuts. When it gets down and dirty, that's when you got to trust your guts. Cause when you're rolling, you just get the chips.
So shift over to the fast lane, brother and sister, and see this story of two throttle jockeys who get into it up to their eyeballs and highballing from American International.
Zorro's back. Zorro, the greatest hero of them all.
Thank God for your life, Sergeant.
Everyone knows the mark. Everyone knows the mask. Everyone cheers his fame. It's the all-new adventures of Zorro. It's all for fun. And fun for all. Zorro, the spirit of adventure. A mystery in a mask. A legend that lives and fights in the biggest adventure of them all. No danger too great. No escape impossible. Zorro's everywhere. It's all new. It's all fantastic. Zorro, the most incredible daredevil in the most spectacular action. It's the all new adventure of Zorro.
Here's to fly high.
This is Dublin. This is my cousin Quaxer. He's a man with very special interests. Some men love food, not Quaxer. Some men love liquor, not Quaxer. My cousin, Quaxer Fortune, has a passion for
Well, let's just say he picks up where others leave off.
You really sell that?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, it's my job.
This is all about Quaxer and what he did to Dublin.
Quaxer!
Quaxer?
Quaxer? Where's Quaxer?
That's Quaxer.
That's Quaxer.
Quaxer, you
are... No, I got something on my mind and I want to talk to you. Now listen.
I have nothing to say to you, Quaxer.
You just listen to me.
Oh, it was foolish in the first place, the whole thing. Quaxer, please, I'm sorry.
How do you think of me?
Quaxer Fortune found true beauty all over Dublin in small, neat piles.
In the year 1987, at Cape Kennedy, NASA launched the last of America's deep space probes. Aboard this compact starship, a lone astronaut, Captain William Buck Rogers, was to experience cosmic forces beyond all comprehension. His trajectory was disrupted by an explosion. In the wink of an eye, his life support systems were frozen by temperatures beyond imagination. Ranger 3 was blown out of its planned trajectory. Buck was frozen by elements so instantaneous and perfect that he was fully preserved and living when found by the forces of the Draconian army and taken aboard the King's flagship Draconia.
Where am I?
We asked the questions. Who are you?
Captain Buck Rogers, United States Air Force. Who are you?
What did he say?
Something about a United States. Captain, what is your destination?
Who are you?
You were aboard the King's flagship Draconia, under command of the Royal Princess Ardala, on its way to Earth on a peace mission.
On its way to Earth? I mean, we're not on? Oh.
Give him something for his discomfort.
Oh. Are you a real-life princess?
I think we've given our captain a little too much medication.
No, I feel great.
And how are we this morning?
Great, where are we going?
We're going home.
Great, where's that?
On Earth.
All right.
I have the strangest feeling I'm going to see Captain Rogers again.
Houston Control, this is Flight 711. Put down the backgammon boards and put away the cards. Lucky Bucky's back.
My kind of town, Chicago is.
Practically a foreign language. Can it be some kind of joke?
Hey, baby, this is quite a setup.
It's Colonel Daring, Commander of Earth's Defenses. Take this barbarian in for interrogation.
Hey, wait a minute.
Captain Buck Rogers, you are now in the 25th century.
I think I will have it right now.
What planet? Oh, it's Earth, of course. You returned as your mission required to almost the precise landing area originally programmed into your ship.
Look, Doc. I've been through a lot. But there is no way you can tell me that that city out there is anything like Chicago.
No, it isn't. There's nothing like Chicago left on Earth.
Tell me about the Holocaust.
I can't. The council will tell you in time.
Look, I lost everything that was important to me. My father, mother, brothers, sisters, a woman I cared for. And until I hear something that convinces me different, they're waiting for me somewhere in time and space right now.
By unanimous vote, the council finds for the state. Captain Rogers, you and your representative, Councilor Theopolis, are banished from the inner cities. You will be removed to Anarchia, there to live out your lives as you see fit.
Well, I never thought I'd say this, but that place back there's starting to look good to me.
I wouldn't start feeling sorry for myself yet. This is nothing compared to what lies ahead.
Well, at least I know part of the story. Go, Twinkie. What brings you out on a night like this?
Captain, I came to find you at some personal risk.
Very ballsy.
Very what?
Welcome aboard the flagship Draconia.
Delighted. This is an unexpected pleasure.
I'm Colonel Deering, commander of the Third Force of the Earth Directorate, and I believe you already know Captain Rogers.
I don't believe we've had the pleasure.
I think you're mistaken, Princess. I never forget a knuckle.
Sir, excuse me. Are you familiar with rock?
No.
What are you doing?
It's called getting down. It's a little before your time, if it frightens you.
Nothing frightens me.
All right, fine. Get down and boogie.
It's expressive.
It's disgusting.
What happens when we bump together?
We automatically become man and wife.
If you're a spy, I'll have to kill you.
That's an example of your best pillow talk. I think I found your problem.
Explode.
That's impossible!
Alert all stations! Secure the ship!
Captain, you stay out of this.
Try and stop me.
Major on your tail. Pull over, I'll get him. Pull up, I can cut him off. Not that way, you're rolling right into his power.
Captain Rogers, I ordered you to stay out of this.
Colonel, you need all the help you can get. Look out, Baker, he's on to you.
anyone who can make a girl feel as happy as Patty can can't be all or bad.
Jesus, I'm after forgetting the paper around.
You know, it wouldn't be so bad if I wasn't such an outletcher.
That poor woman just wanted to vent her pent on a gent without a cent.
That's what I like about the Irish. Everybody's a
poet. That little mart in the pub really was a flower. And a pretty flower should be watered every day.
Bet you tell that to all the girls.
Love them all, but not in the heart. Blow yourself a kiss in the mirror every morning and it'll last for days.
Stuck.
Can I help?
Oh!
I should have worn me pants with the buttons.
I think I taught you everything.
The hardest working lad in the parish.
You seduced my housekeeper.
She knows the way to a man's heart.
What did you do for an encore? Lay an egg. Can you deny that you placed your hemlock person inside the innocent bowery of that dear gentlewoman?
Oh God, don't the Irish ever look inside their trousers?
There's no end to it.
She's got a pal. A real angel.
Oh, Jesus. An angel.
And the sea comes up to meet me as I stand upon the sand. And her eyes return to greet me, and she seems to understand. For she's making a demand.
Paddy McGuire has one hand on his dreams, one hand on his girls, and one foot out the door.
Dear Mom and Dad, I've gone to Chicago to seek fame and fortune. Don't be mad. Love, T.R. Later. T.S. Traffic accident?
Hi, Mom. Nothing. I just called to see how you were. How are you? No, really, nothing's wrong. I just wanted to see how you were. Listen, Mom, how's Dad anyway? How is he? Oh, Mom, would you please don't wake him up. Please don't wake him up, Mom. Would you please not wake him up? Hi, Dad.
Have you ever had malaria, tuberculosis, rheumatic fever, heart disease, kidney disease, or any mental illness?
No, 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 no.
Have you ever been convicted of a felony?
12 arrests, no convictions.
And to push the button for the desired floor, step to the rear of the elevator and...
expect you to think of your desk as your home during the day, so to speak. Just as you wouldn't keep a dirty home, we don't think you should keep a messy desk. Now, look up and down your row, Miss Baskin. That is your row.
Hello, T.R.?
Yes?
My name is Jack Mitchell. I've just arrived in town. Larry gave me your name. Hello, T.R.?
This is the living room.
Nice.
And this is your bedroom. I think two bedrooms is mandatory, if you know what I mean. Listen, what you do is your own business, if you know what I mean.
Larry told me a lot about you.
What did he say?
He said, when I get to Chicago, I should be sure to look you up.
Really? That's a lot to say.
T.R. is an absolutely super reader.
Really? What do you like best?
Mostly Lebanese classics.
Nice.
I know I'm not so smart, but even I know when someone's making fun of me.
You sound like one of those women's liberation people. Now, a woman should get stimulation. She'd get stimulation out of a home and children. What do you think, T.R.?
I think you're a schmuck.
You're making fun of me. Larry never said you were going to give me such a hard time.
You happen to be acting like a blob. I don't understand it.
What are you giving him a hard time for?
You're absolutely right, Jack Mitchell. I have no right to give you a hard time, especially if Larry never told you I would. No siree, no hard time, not from this cookie. Who the hell is Larry? What's your name?
Larry. Larry Moore. What does T.R. stand for?
Thelma Ritter.
You're my favorite actress.
to fit in, you know, I really do. But do you know what scares me more than anything else in the world? I'm afraid that if you keep on getting disappointed, you wind up expecting less.
Stars. He moves out to the endless interstellar reaches of the universe. An advanced exploration corps, a new breed of pioneer, must seek out unstable planets and destroy them.
Drive sequence begun. Hit it, Pinback.
Mission of the 21st century planet smashers, Dark Star. 20 years in space, 1 million light years from Earth. Their job is to clear a path for the colonization of space.
Back home in Malibu. I used to surf a lot, Talby. I used to be a great surfer.
Travel in an infinite universe with mind-melting excitement from beyond the stars.
Computer to bomb number 20. Return to the bomb bay immediately.
But I have received the operational signal.
Hello, bomb. Are you with me?
I wish I had more time.
Why don't you have more time?
Because I must detonate. I must detonate.
Commander Powell. Commander Powell, this is Doolittle. Can you hear me?
Man? What happened, man?
Hey.
Confirmed.
Power drive sequence activated.
Roger, retracted. Lock all defensive systems.
Dark Star. They're not lost in space. They're loose.
Space. And time. Two dimensions we dream of conquering. But perhaps they have already been conquered. Not by man, but a form of intelligence far more evolved and far more powerful. A Time Walker. The Discovery.
I simply sealed him alive in a corner of Tut's tomb.
The Awakening.
This was in the coffin.
The Search.
Looks like some kind of wiring schematic.
The power.
Nobody's that strong.
Crystals could be used as transmitters.
The cells are multiplying at a rate so fast, I can hardly measure it.
The confrontation.
It's definitely no longer dormant.
Thank you. Now, our time belongs to him. The story of a journey home. Time Walker. Nothing can stop him, not even time.
Hiya, Ben, Nick. Been looking all over town for you. We sent Murphy down to Kansas City to see Mary Ann. And this is how they sent him back.
What should I do with these, Mr. Devlin?
Oh, did you know Murphy?
Yeah.
Was he a good guy?
Oh, yeah, he's a good guy.
Then bury him.
Lee Marvin and the boys are coming to town. Gene Hackman and his boys are waiting for them.
Nick.
Marianne. You eat guts.
Yeah. I like them.
Talk now, eat later. Nice to see you in the same old rat hole. You tell Marianne that I'm here. And not to get any fancy ideas about turning me or any of my boys into hamburger. You got it.
Lee Marvin, Gene Hackman. Together they're murder in Prime Cut.
Yeah, real smart. You and Jake, you think you're big men. Walk in anyway. You take down your pants and I'll take down mine. We'll see who's the biggest man.
Why don't we just ask Clara?
They tell stories about you now. Good, tough ones. Did you come here for Marianne, Nick, or me?
Marianne.
Marianne is freezing things at the ice house. Me, I'm already thawed.
What do you think of all this, Nick?
I think it stinks.
This is my country.
Yeah.
I give it just what it wants. Dope and flesh. Something up the arm. Something to lick around the belly. You have a good time last night? Huh?
Lee Marvin. Gene Hackman. Prime Cut. The gangster film that's a cut above.
In the great tradition of American classics, we bring you Surf 2, the end of the trilogy. The surf wars continue when a mad genius pollutes innocent surfer youth and the free beaches of America.
Do you know how many brain surgeons, nuclear physicists, or Nobel laureates have been surfers? I'll tell you, none.
It's a sprawling surf saga of rebellion, romance.
Oh, I'm Bob.
Adventure beneath boiling seas, struggle against uncontrolled substances, and a race to the death by freedom fighters, protecting your right to surf and the American way.
Must be from L.A.
Surf 2, with music by the Stray Cats, Oingo Boingo, Split Ends, The Circle Jerks, The Beach Boys, and more. Surf 2, the adventure that dares to trash school, police, parents, the beach itself, and the two greatest American institutions of all time.
Don't stop innocent kids from drinking cola and surfing. It's the American way.
It's the final confrontation of the Surf Wars trilogy. If you missed Surf 1, you owe it to yourself to see Surf 2.
Punks and creeps. Think these guys would be mature enough to take surfing seriously.
It's twice the fun of Surf 1. Surf 2.
Charles Arthur Floyd was a poor kid from the Peckerwoods who parlayed a little ambition and a lot of ammunition into a successful career in the bank robbing business. Got nowhere to go. The girls who loved him and the men who hunted him called him Pretty Boy.
Got nowhere to stay, but I'm staying. I can't run no more, but the more I run, oh Lord.
If you do wrong, the world will say goodbye. And if you do right, who knows how hard you try. You know, the world's gonna make you cry. And you
you can't come home until the day you die.
Got nowhere to go, but I'm going. Got nowhere to stay. I can't run no more, but the more I run, oh Lord, I see it's me I'm running from.
Into each life they say some rain must fall, but it seems in mine I've got it all. There will be no one that I'm gonna call my friend, or I'll take no one along to do.
Got nowhere to go, but I'm going. Got nowhere to stay, but I'm staying. I can't run no more, but the more I run, oh Lord, I see it's me I'm running from.
His name is Lyle Swan. He's racing against the clock.
Stand by for automatic.
In more ways than one.
Perimeter violation. Sector 4.
Derek, is that for real?
Because this ride, instead of taking him 1,000 miles forward, will take him 105 years backward.
Dr. Savage, wheel!
Sector 2.
One. Perimeter violations.
Abort, send back.
Time Rider, the adventure of Lyle Swan.
If I'm right, sir, he stepped out around 1875.
Man, am I glad to see you.
He just happened to be in the right place at the wrong time.
I was wondering if maybe you could show me on this map here where I am.
And fate gave him a present.
Hey, you okay?
Of the past.
Where are you going?
Only trouble was, he didn't know it.
What was that? Where'd it go?
I don't know.
Hey, what the hell's happening here, huh?
He didn't understand the people.
Hey, why are those guys shooting at me like that?
And they didn't understand him.
Where'd these come from? I'm thinking twice, mostly. See, I hang with technoid types. We party and they come up with all this Bonnaroo boogie.
In short, everything was different.
Take off your clothes.
Well,
what?
Almost everything.
You heard me, Mr. Swan.
Time Rider, the adventure of Lyle Swan.
General Lee had that machine. We won the war.
The past, present fantasy of a desert racer. A beautiful gunslinger.
Where are you from, my friend?
Canoga Park, L.A.
A renegade priest.
Beautiful, senor. Where did you get this map?
Got it at an Exxon station.
And assorted bad guys.
Jumped up and down on it. Up and down. Kicked it.
Time Rider, the adventure of Lyle Swan. An off-road racer who's way, way off the road.
These two men are New York City police officers. They earn $43 a day, risking their lives as cops.
Get your hands off of me!
Today, they'll earn $10 million, risking their lives as robbers.
What is this?
It's a robbery. What do you think it is? You want bearer bonds, $10 million worth. Nothing over $100,000, nothing under
$20,000. Who are they?
I swear I don't know.
Who called them?
Elliot Kastner presents Cops and Robbers, starring Joseph Bologna and Cliff Gorman. Cops and Robbers. Nothing else comes close. Power, a Sidney Lumet film. Enter the bizarre world of the psychosexual mind. From Carlo Ponti, who brought you Dr. Zhivago, now... Torso. 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 It saturates the screen with terror. Torso. Rated R.
Would you come out with me sometime?
I don't go out very much.
Why not?
Oh, I get home late most evenings.
All right, then. What about a Sunday? Next Sunday.
I just told you I don't go out very much.
Because of your leg. I was just trying to kiss you.
Some women in love will do anything a man asks. Some men will ask anything.
I didn't want to, and I don't want to, but there's £500 involved. They want to know about security arrangements, so...
I'm not going to do it.
But it's so simple. It's really so simple.
Nobody's asking you to steal anything, Dick.
Why?
Ted says the stuff must be worth at least $150,000. We get a third of it.
It's impossible. The place is riddled with alarm systems and guards. Suppose I tell them what they want to know. Will you not get involved with it?
It's too late, love.
Did you know who's married?
Now, what are we asking you to do? We're asking you to kill the alarm on the back door and open it. Well, it's simple. Sit down.
Leave?
No, don't upset yourself.
Leave, please, make them go away. Will you ask them to leave me alone?
Look, Jack, just...
Some women in love will do anything a man asks. Some men will ask anything. It's the time to be young. It's the time to be wild. It's the time to be in love. Teenage Graffiti, the sign of the times.
What are you doing with yourself now that you've graduated? Thanks.
in some trouble.
No one does it like the teenagers do it. And they do it all in Teenage Graffiti.
After the bomb, the past becomes a dream where cars are things that grow in trees and comic books are real.
Your city's metropolis has lots of cars and all the clothes are white and all the people can fly.
I'm not here to steal your food or feel your women. I have a show. Now, the miracle. Cereal!
Is there a city? Tell me about the city. What is the city really like? Take me to the city! Maybe you're gonna have some babies.
Do you love me, Randa?
We're not animals, we're people! We have to start living like people! We have to be civilized! What's your name?
Sydney Miller.
I'm Glenn and she's Randa.
I haven't seen anyone in 20 years.
But her! Oh!
She's gonna have the baby.
Doris Day and Polaroid and Palisades Park and Safeway and Rock and Roll and Prince Valiant and the Holland Tunnel and Playboy and Miss January and Mick Jagger.
In 1836, he moved like a shadow through the mountains and forests of southern Canada and Montana. Only one white man had ever seen him. His own people, the Blackfoot, were in awe of him. They said he could see like an eagle, smell like a wolf, and run like an antelope. As a warrior, he was terrifying. When his people were dying of smallpox, he stepped out of the shadows and asked the white man for medicine. He got treachery and bullets instead. In revenge, he kidnapped a white girl and boy, and in an incredible journey, outmaneuvered a group of mountain men through the high country for almost a year. His name was Winter Hawk, and his story was only told around Blackfoot campfires until now. Charles B. Pierce brings it to the wide screen as one of the epic adventure films of all time. Winter Hawk, rated PG.
Film of the year, all new, totally different. Superman Chu, master of kung fu. He's super cool. Super quick. Super deadly. Superman Chu. His body a lethal weapon capable of destroying anything and anyone who gets in his way. Action to blow your mind. Blows to leave you breathless. kicks defying physical limitations. Superman Chu, master of kung fu.
You think I have such a short life?
That I don't know. But you know what they say. Courage makes heroes.
They sent their best men to get him, but their best was not good enough to tangle with Superman Chu. If you haven't seen this kind of action film before, you can't afford to miss this one. Even if you've seen the others, you owe it to yourself to see the best. Superman Chu, master of kung fu. See it to believe your eyes. From Capitol Productions, rated R for Righteous.
Boot Hill is where death comes quick. Boot Hill is where death comes hard. Boot Hill is where death comes often. Because in Boot Hill, death comes in two colors. Terrence Hill is the man with no name, and Woody Strode as the gunfighter are the colors of death in Boot Hill.
I don't like to have to thank somebody too many times.
You're not the one I'm looking for. But you'll make good bait for my trap. That's the only reason for me to try to keep you alive.
Boot Hill, filled with the violence of the West. Victor Buono is Honey. He owned the town.
Noise or not, take as many men as you need and do whatever you want. But at tomorrow's meeting, I don't want to hear anything more about those people.
Lionel Stander as Mummy saves his friends and buries his enemies.
I'll take that bullet out of him, all right. I'll cure him. I'll make him well. And then I'll run out, borrow a gun, to shoot him in a place it'll take.
Eduardo Cianelli as the commissioner. He wrote his own laws.
You see now, Judge, we...
Don't call me Judge, sir.
No, Your Honor.
And not even Your Honor.
Bud Spencer as Hutch, killed for a town that didn't care.
You see that? Look at the mess we got ourselves in. I told you we were wasting time with this bunch. Not even an earthquake will get them moving.
There's one other thing to do before day comes.
What?
You realize if they don't listen to me, they'll all end up 6 feet under. And so will their wives and their children. Because after Finch takes care of those four idiots, he won't spare anyone.
This is Boot Hill, where nobody died of natural causes. Film Ventures International release, filmed in Technicolor and Techniscope.
And now it's Richie and Spiro. See the hilarious antics of America's funniest comedy team of the decade, Richie and Spiro. in the absurd fast-moving motion picture, Another Nice Mess. You are the leader
of the land. My fellow Americans, as you know, I am a great supporter of the motion picture industry. Make no mistake about that. But I urge you not to see a picture called Another Nice Mess. It ridicules the American way of life. But more importantly, Another Nice Mess is a film that attempts to make buffoons out of this country's leaders.
Now you run it up the pole, and I'll salute.
You know, Richie, I like the idea of us being vice president.
Well, here's another nice mess you've got me into.
Does this mean you won't let me be vice president anymore?
I'll give you 10 seconds to get me down. One.
Yes, it's Richie and Spiro. Meet America's funniest comedy team of the decade, Richie and Spiro, in the outrageously absurd motion picture, Another Nice Mess.
Nine.
Join the hilarity in the White House.
11. 12. 13.
See Another Nice Mess, starring Rich Little and Herb Volan, written and directed by Bob Einstein, produced by Tom Smothers and Jonathan Hayes. A Fine Films release, rated PG. Parental guidance suggested.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States, Hubert Heber.
You blew it, you blew it, you blew it.
This radio classic of the 30s was the birth of the blues. They've happened in the news.
The rumor that the president would veto the bill is reported to have come from a high white horse souse.
You knew it the moment you blew it.
They've also happened in weather reports.
That's the weather report from the International Airport here at Anchorage, Alaska. Now I'll take a leak out the window to see if it's freezing outside our studio.
You blew it. Oh, how could you do it?
Sportscasters have been the victims of bloopers, too.
Clock shows 28 seconds to go. Looks like a pass. It is a pass. It's intercepted by Ostrowski. He's up to the 10, the 20, the 30. He tries the midfield strike. Look at that sound! Run!
Yes, bloopers are truly the greatest unintentional comedy of radio and TV. They've happened in every broadcasting category. Let's listen to this classic example from a famous children's radio program.
And this is your Uncle Don saying good night. Good night, little kids, good night. We're off? Good, well, that ought to hold a little...
You blew it, you blew it.
From the world's greatest collection of radio and TV's most hilarious mistakes comes a great new movie that will leave you rolling in the aisles. Kermit Schaefer proudly presents Pardon My Blooper, based on his best-selling books and award-winning record albums that have kept millions of blooper fans all over the world laughing for years. For the first time ever, the best of the bloopers now come to life on the motion picture screen.
And now before I ask you our first question, what do you do for a living, my good lady?
I'm a maid and I take care of a large family.
How large your family?
Let's see, 4 boys, 3 girls, 1 adult, and 1 adulteress.
You blew it, darling, you blew it.
Pardon My darn, Blooper is an incredible it. Movie they said would be impossible to make. But the super blooper snooper it, himself, Kermit Schaefer, has put it all together so everyone can relive the interesting history, heartwarming nostalgia, and rib-splitting comedy of radio and television's greatest goofs, which includes this memorable commercial.
August for the breast. Best bread and rolls. Oh, good luck. And when you go into the store tomorrow, ask for August Brothers for the best bread and rolls you have ever tasted. I knew that had to happen one night, friends.
Pardon My Blooper is only being shown in movie theaters.
Senator Fulbright,
Do you think that the Viet Cong will honor the peace?
They are, as I said already, they have conducted themselves in the last two or three years much more discreet, with greater prudence and discretion than we have, because indeed, I forgotten what the question was.
He blew it, but don't you blow your chance to see Pardon My Blooper. Uncensored, unbleeped, shocking, and provocative virgin, version of blooper fun for everyone. You'll agree that it's the craziest f***ing movie you've ever seen. Coming soon to this theater.
You blew it, you blew it, you blew it.
Director who brought you Smokey and the Bandit, Hooper, Cannonball Run, comes the ultimate spectacle. Megaforce, an elite compact fighting unit armed with the most sophisticated weapons ever seen on a movie screen. The mission, to preserve freedom and justice and battle the forces of evil.
The good guys always win. Even in the 80s.
Megaforce.
The story you're about to see is based on fact. A frustrated burglary squad is in a desperate situation.
I mean, we bust them, and then the courts let them go, right?
John, what are you talking about?
What we do is we set ourselves up as fences.
You want the police to buy stolen goods?
Exactly.
Are you crazy? Why don't we join the mob?
Columbia Pictures presents... Dom DeLuise. Suzanne Clichette. Jerry Reed. Ossie Davis. And the biggest lineup of crooks, schnooks, and case histories on record. In Hot Stuff. The story of the most successful fencing operation ever run.
You're under arrest.
By cops. So, hold on to your hat, your car, your portable TV, your electric guitar, your transistor radio, your cops, your robbers, your fish, your raft, your hair, your van, your motorcycle, your surfboard, your sanity.
Little Orphan Annie in Florida.
Sugar.
And your sense of humor. Because only one person could take a story this true and make it seem so unbelievable.
I'm hiding behind Gasoline!
Dom DeLuise. Hot Stuff. You won't believe it, but it really happened.
Hot Stuff.
Old West. Tough times that made tough people. People like Billy the Kid, Calamity Jane, and Jesse James. But there was nobody quite like Sonny and Jed Trigado. In lawless times, they made their own law.
Okay, Mr. Toronto, what are the rules?
You got to do things by the rules.
Is there something else I could get you, sir?
Yep. Your money.
This is a holdup.
Sonny and Jed. It's about that special kind of love between a man and a woman.
I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get myself a gun, and I'm gonna be just like you. Number 19, now pay me!
Oh, she's kidding. She fell on her head as a kid. She's not very normal and can be very dangerous, isn't she funny?
In the Old West, an outlaw woman stood behind her man. Three steps behind.
You wanna stay with me? That is, if I decide I'm gonna keep you with me.
You gotta walk 3 steps in back of me.
I can put the next bullet between your eyes, but you're not gonna die that easy, punk. Come on, let's go.
Every time you thought you had them nailed, you got burned. Sonny and Jed, they changed the West a little, and each other a lot.
I declare you man and wife from now till it's death when you fish. Are parted. Unless you wish something more.
Your wallet.
Wallet? Yeah, your wallet. Didn't you hear her? And if somebody asks you who robbed you, you said Jed and Sonny Trigado.
Sonny and Jed. The reason they call the West wild.
Hiram Jaffe's world is just like yours. A little unreal.
Dolly!
You listen to that noise?
Move.
Some people think move is about moving.
Like I'm setting something into motion, Dolly, something I don't understand.
Some people think move is about the system breaking down.
You lousy kids, no respect for anything.
Some people think move is about today's plastic culture.
What is that supposed to mean?
We believe in a philosophy of joy and laughter, not in self-recrimination and rebuke.
No shit.
Some people think move is about the battle of the sexes.
Doctor, I don't think my husband understands me.
Is your wife Zoroastrian?
No, Jewish.
Ida, break up the glass.
Isn't that disgusting?
I don't know what it is. I haven't made love to Dolly in months. I just can't.
God, I think you really are going crackers.
And look, this is the third time. And you better tell me you love me or something. Hey, look at that. You've got green paint spots all over your chest. You've even got it on your... Oh, that's kinky.
You gonna try something funny?
None, mate.
When we start picking up weird balls, I come for you first.
Some people think move is just an entertaining comedy.
Who is this?
But some people think move is more than that.
Damn it! I don't need this.
In short, some people think, and some people don't. And some people just move. Move.
Jaffe!
The movie with a message.
Move. 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 La, 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 la.
Hello, America.
This is Miss America. Coonskin's coming. And I'm in it. This is it. Coonskin, this is really it.
Say, Rabbit, if you hit what you think with a plan, now listen to this, now listen to this, now listen to this. Advice from your ace boom man.
Thank you.
can take me.
This is it. This is really it.
Babes will rise with the boys who light hellfires.
Let's get out of here!
Hell's Bells. Hip chicks with an itch for the kind of action it takes a lot of man to scratch.
Play with that dumb old thing.
Cherry, baby. It ain't even broke in yet.
Well, neither am I.
Oh, ain't this nice?
What's going on?
You take good care of him, honey. Just like you did for us.
Well, I have the good sense to know when to walk away from a bad partner.
Oh, I can see you've never felt that strong about anyone.
You recognize those bikes?
They're like men, all the same. What are you planning to do?
Get my bike back.
You're crazy. There's 10 of them. You'd never stand a
chance.
That's
my worry. Go on, Buston.
When they fight, anything goes. When they love,
please hold me.
Everything goes.
Wealthy Elgar Enders never had the chance to live in a slum, so he bought one.
Bon-Ton Heights, that's its official name, will start a trend in urban renewal, Mr. Enders.
This neighborhood's going to be very chic, very chic. Let's hope this influx of the beautiful people is the beginning of an inclination.
What is this we have here?
I'm Elgar Enders, the new landlord.
You hold us right there, monkey.
Are you the new landlord?
I own this house. I'm the new landlord.
You have until the count of three.
I am the new landlord.
These arrows have been dipped in Fanny's barbecue sauce.
Cigarette pops?
Like it and meet myself.
My heavens, it's good to meet you.
Hi.
I'm Elgar Enders.
My name's Laney.
William Jr.
William Jr.
Peter.
Are you with Vista? Is this some sort of a new program or something?
No. That's Elgar.
You think I'm white, don't you?
This real estate is very important to me. It's the most important thing I've ever done. I'm a Cancerian, and home is very important.
You're a Leo.
No, Mother, I'm a Cancer.
When were you born?
The roof leaks. The toilet runs all day.
I'm going to put in a patio right here.
My, it's hot in here.
It's really cool, Mr. Enders.
You awful cute to be a landlord.
Oh, we're insecticide and deodorant.
Is that carbonated?
Oh, he's just ruthless. He's ruthless.
Napalm.
You can get at those hawks a little better if you take your gloves off.
I think there's something that you should know, Mother.
What's that, dear?
I think I love a girl who's a Negro.
Didn't we all go together to see Guess Who's Coming to Dinner?
Elgar, I'm going to come straight to the point.
If you march into this house with an armful of pickaninnies, the best you're going to be able to expect from me will be a swift kick.
The Mirisch Production Company presents The Landlord.
Okay?
Okay!
Starring Pearl Bailey as Marge, Diana Sands, Lee Grant, and Bo Bridges as The Landlord.
So, I bought this house.
I know exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to get chosen for the Olympic team.
Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer presents
A Brian Forbes film, International Velvet.
Will there ever be another horse like him?
There might.
An unforgettable story in which a new legend is born.
It's the foal!
About two women separated by a generation.
Joan, wake up! Wake up quickly! She's gone again!
Sarah!
Get off! Come here. You stupid little idiot. What the hell do you think you're doing?
Riding.
You don't ever ride my horse. You don't ever ride my horse without my permission. Do you understand?
But joined by the dream they share.
But you were like me. You told me. You told me you were only interested in the pie and that nothing else mattered.
She wasn't running away from us. She was just running. Her parents are dead, killed in horrifying circumstances. She's shipped off to a strange country, meets an aunt she doesn't know,
and an uncle who isn't her uncle, and dumped in some bloody awful school. Well, come on.
I know all that, but why can't I talk to her?
In every girl is the woman she's destined to become. And in every woman is the girl she used to be.
Why did you stop riding? Well, it was the oldest reason in the world. I lost my nerve.
Wouldn't exactly call it riding, would we? Staying on a horse, perhaps. And tell me, where did you learn what you call riding?
Arizona.
Oh, in the colonies. Now, when I take somebody, if I take somebody, they come on my terms and they work my way. No nonsense, no temperament, no alibis, and certainly no question of my admitting that I'm ever wrong. And total dedication.
I've been chosen. They picked me. I'm riding this time.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Can I buy you a Coke to celebrate?
Sure, sure.
So, I'll see you in the stadium tomorrow. And win or lose, I'll take you to dinner. Is that a date?
That's a date.
What is important in the games is not the winning, taking part.
Don't do it for me. Do it for your father. He won the Grand National.
Go out there and prove how wrong I was.
You've got to show him.
You'll feel the thrills, share the excitement, and cheer for her in a story of winning and losing and all the growing up in between. International Velvet, starring Tatum O'Neill, Christopher Plummer, Anthony Hopkins, and Nanette Newman. International Velvet.
Dear Mom and Dad, I've been at a sleepaway camp for almost 3 weeks. And I'm getting very scared.
Welcome to sleepaway camp. Someone is watching you.
Hey, Mama, Reba!
Someone is waiting for you. Someone wants to scare you to death. Sleepaway camp. You won't be coming home.
There's a special night in the lives of all of us. A night to be beautiful, to be desirable. A night we can break all the rules and make our own. Prom night. Everyone at Hamilton High is getting ready for prom night. It's a day of rehearsals, arrangements, final preparations, and last-minute phone calls.
Nick?
Wendy, do you still like to play games?
They're too old for games. But someone still wants to play.
Why? Kelly. It's been a long time. Tonight, it's my turn.
Everything is on. Tonight, someone has come to the prom alone. Someone who watches in the silent corridors.
Kelly.
Help!
Someone who waits until no one can help. Prom night.
Now.
If you're not back by midnight, you won't be coming home.
I shall create for you an army of humanoids, indestructible human robots.
This is the day of the humanoid, when man faces his greatest challenge from outer space. See them duel with laser guns and lethal arrows of shimmering Phlegathon. Discover the secret of Tauntaun, who disarms a mutant space creature programmed to kill. Cheer Kip, the robo-dog, as he blasts invaders from the blue planet Noxon. This time they come too close. The humanoid.
You're lost. Everyone looks strange to you.
They are prisoners of their own nightmares.
That's you.
You'll face your phobia head on.
They are tormented by their own fears.
You're running for your life, Laura.
No! Don't touch me!
They are trapped by their own terrors.
Look up. There's no one with the child.
She's gonna fall.
And they are about to become the victims of a killer who has discovered the perfect murder weapon. The human mind.
Was it an accident or suicide?
Of course, as far as I'm concerned, the prime suspects are your experimentee.
Be careful. Just be careful.
Four out of five patients in this project are dead. Now the deaths must link up somehow.
For 2,000 years, the sacred art of the ninja has been guarded in the East.
Remember the day I found you.
Now, it has come to the West.
Remember what is hidden deep in your mind.
He is the only soldier.
Date of birth unknown.
The only American.
Who is he?
Who is capable of defeating the secret Black Star Army. The mission to hijack a U.S. military arsenal.
Your destiny, my son, awaits you.
The adventure. The confrontation. The final hour. The deadliest art of the Orient.
is now in the hands of an American. American Ninja.
From Wes Craven, director of A Nightmare on Elm Street, comes a story of the forbidden world between life and death.
There's a door to the mystical.
And you just walked through it.
Somebody brought him back from the grave. And I want to know how they did it.
Death is not the end.
I'll take your soul.
You think you can take these people's secrets and just walk away?
In the shadows of the imagination lies the ultimate nightmare.
Don't let them bury me. I'm not dead.
The Serpent and the Rainbow.
Today to bear witness to the execution of Horace Pinker, whose unspeakable atrocities have horrified the people of this great state. He stands convicted of 52 counts of aggravated assault, 23 counts of armed robbery, and 37 counts of murder in the first degree. Prisoner, have any final words?
Yeah. No more Mr. Nice Guy.
I don't think he's dead.
Contact.
He's among you.
Now, Wes Craven brings you his greatest creation.
No more!
Shocker.